Just behind that in Arlington National Cemetery is Section 60 of Arlington, where Iraq and Afghanistan veterans are buried. And, you know, this is our nation's longest war, as we've mentioned. Our fathers and grandfathers fought in World War II, in Korea, in Vietnam. But this war on terror, this is my generation's war. And the difference here is that it's still ongoing. It hasn't ended 16 years on, and unfortunately, I think we're just in the beginning stages of it.
Well, the question I was going to ask you, and it's John Scott, Colonel Maltz.
I wanted
to ask, in the fight against terrorism, do you see the glass as half empty or half full?
Well, I think it depends on how you look at it. On the one hand, we haven't had another 9/11. We haven't had an attack of this magnitude at least. You know, we've had the other inspired attacks in San Bernardino and others, but we haven't had another 9/11. So in that sense, defensively, it's been a success, and a lot of credit should go to our intelligence agencies and our law enforcement officers for making that happen. Offensively, of course, we've taken out Osama bin Laden, and we've eliminated a lot of al-Qaeda sanctuaries, but it has turned into a global movement. So on the hard power side, I'd say we've had some success, but on the soft power side, we need to do a lot more to undermine this ideology of Islamic extremism. We did that against the ideology of communism, but it took several decades. I want to see things like girls' education, women's empowerment, things that go to the heart of this extremist ideology that's bastardized Islam. And it's that longer term strategy where I think we could do a lot more, and that's how we're going to win in the long run. But unfortunately, that's going to take quite some time. And we're seeing with Afghanistan in particular, but in other places, that this is now becoming a generational war. My soldiers in the early stages of Afghanistan are now sending their children off to this effort. And I think, you know, we're going to continue to need to see national leadership on what it's going to take to win this long war.